Hey everybody. So on 4th of July weekend, I went out and I purchased on Craigslist this Meade LX50. It's a 10-inch Schmidt Cassegrain grain. It's got a focal ratio of 10, so it's an F10 telescope. And as you can tell, it is fork mounted. And the purpose of this today is to defork the LX50 and the 10-inch OTA. And what I want to do is eventually get this mounted on my Paramount MyT. Now we know that the Paramount MyT has a 50-pound weight limit. The OTA itself should weigh in about 22 to 25 pounds, so I've got more than enough capacity on the MyT to carry this thing. I sold my Celestron 11-inch about a year ago. And I always knew I'd be buying another big telescope, but at the time I wasn't able to balance a 35-pound OTA, nor was I in the mood to shell out all the money for the proper counterweights. I now have some counterweights I think will make this balance, and so I went out and bought this. As far as I can tell, the electronics and everything in this work just fine. It does have an RA tracking drive, and the RA tracking drive does work. I was able to test that out at my house. The declination, however, because this is a push-to, it can't do a full range of motion. It's only got about 15 degrees in declination that it can move. It's got two gears here that a declination motor will move and allow this to move back and forth about 15 or so degrees. So it's not a full range of motion. Originally, this was a push-to telescope. It's got some encoders inside of it. The encoders, as far as I can tell, are working. The hand controller was a Magellen II hand controller, and it does work. I was able to input the date and time. I was able to go to a few stars inside of the hand controller and do kind of a fake polar alignment using those when I bought the telescope. It also came with a Meade wedge to make this polar alignable rather than just being an alt azimuth mount. So with this telescope this old, it's about 20, 22 years old, something like that. A lot of the technology has advanced so far. And like I said, I've got the Paramount MyT that would be a dream mount to have this telescope on versus a 20 something year old push-to system. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and start taking this thing apart. Now the general strategy that I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the fork arm that's closest to me, and then remove the bolts along the telescope over here that hold this arm to the telescope, and then just remove it. The reason why I'm going to completely remove this fork arm on this side and leave this fork here is there's a gearbox and a motor here, and I want this to stay in place. I have to remove it to get to the four bolts inside of here, and that's a lot of extra work I don't want to have to go through. If I wanted to sell this later on and I make a mistake taking this apart and I break a piece, I'm probably not going to be able to find a replacement part for it, and I would ultimately like this fork mount system to be used for somebody who has a broken LX50 and might need some parts for it. So I want to keep as much of this intact as possible. So again, we're going to take this arm off and then just remove the bolts over here and then pull the OTA off. So to do that, I need my 3/16 Allen drive bit, and we're going to just put that into my power drill. Like so. Thank you. So got four of these bolts here, and they are quite rusted. Again, this is a 20-something-year-old telescope system, and there's no telling how many times that this was outside. I know that the guy that I bought it from, he said he had purchased it like 10 years prior to selling it to me, and he had only ever taken it out twice. He used it to show his children when they were younger the moon, and I think he said Saturn or Jupiter or something like that one night, and they weren't very impressed with it. I guess his kids weren't into astronomy, and so he decided to put it in the garage and maybe bring it out another night. And 10 years later, that never happened, and he was cleaning out his garage, and I guess his wife told him that it had to go. So he put it on Craigslist and listed it for sale. I was able to snag it for a really, really good price. I don't know that I should disclose what I paid for it, but you know, some people online who know what I gave for it would probably agree that it was practically highway robbery, what he was asking for, and what we ultimately ended up settling down as a fair price. In my defense, there was a lot of evidence that the tracking, or not the tracking, but the declination drive motor wasn't working at all. And it turns out it was just a bad power connection, and I was able to fix that at my house, and everything does indeed work. But we were able to work out a fair price on account of me not getting the telescope in the working condition he thought it was in from the last time that he had used it. So went ahead and packed it up, brought it home, and started ordering some new parts for it. I've got two Losmandy D-style dovetails with the mounting hardware here for it. And these basically just fit right onto here, and another piece will go on back here, and then this Losmandy dovetail would just bolt on like that. And that's how I plan on mating this to the Paramount MyT. I bought two of these, one for the bottom, one for the top. If you've seen some of my other YouTube videos, you know that I have a way of mounting an imaging computer as well as all of my cable management on top of the OTA now, and can control it wirelessly, and I'm going to do that with this at some point. It's not something that I've got the finances to do just yet, but hopefully in the next couple of months I will be able to get the computer hardware for that and have everything ready to go in my observatory for remote observations. I would really like to start doing some more of these YouTube live outreaches, a virtual telescope from my backyard, and you know, we can play around with that, see about having you guys join in and share the events as they happen to Twitter, Reddit, Facebook, wherever you frequently are online, and see if we can't maybe get a little online digital community for doing star parties. A telescope like this is great for doing planets, Saturn, Jupiter, the two ice giants, Uranus and Neptune would probably look really, really great through this telescope, as well as possibly doing some of the smaller DSOs like the Ring Nebula. I'd be really excited to try this out with doing a long-term astrophotography, but for that I'm probably going to need a guide scope, and I might be able to reuse this as a guide scope. But I'm going to take this off just for now while I'm deforking it so it's not in the way. And another thing is this tube, being as old as it is, it's got a lot of scratches and scuff marks. The paint's kind of faded in some spots. It's got a lot of dust and dirt all over it. And at some point, I would like to flock the inside of this OTA. And that'll help with some of the contrast, some of the stray light bouncing around on the inside. And if I do flock the inside of this. That's going to involve taking the primary mirror out of the back, the corrector plate and secondary mirror off of the front, and essentially just having this OTA by itself. And I think I would like to repaint it. This midnight blue that Meade is known for is a really cool color, and I wouldn't have any problem staying with it. But my mount, the Paramount MyT, is kind of like this Italian racing red color. And then, of course, you know, I could just do like jet black or white or some other color. And if you guys have a suggestion for another color that you think that this should be painted, just put a comment down below. And there's a little poll that you can click over here and just pick your choice. And if you want to leave a comment, just tell me that you... it's another color, and you commented what color it should be. Excuse me. Allergies have been bad here in Texas. Some of you who might be watching undoubtedly probably feel my pain. In fact, this might be the most unpopular live stream ever. There are nobody watching yet. I wonder if I made this public or not. It says it's public. This should be the last screw to take off the OTA, and it should then be free of the forks. But I need to save these little ones for right now. And there we go. Oh wow, it's got a date sticker on it of 4/2/99, so it's 17 years old. So that's how long this how old this telescope is. 17 years old. That is insane. I have friends who have children that aren't even this old yet. And I'm sure some of you who are watching this or are going to be watching this are probably thinking, I don't even have grandchildren that old yet. But there we go. We have one deforked Meade OTA. 10 inches of planet hunting awesomeness. Since I got it like this, and I can point this out, a focal reducer slash field flattener that I had bought. Now this is a Meade 4000 series focal reducer and field flattener, and I believe that this is going to do just fine if I can get the correct spacing. I have some extension tubes on order. They're coming from China, of all places, but I gotta put those on the back of this. And then this would probably mate to the extension tubes. I believe I need to put 65 millimeters of space between the rear cell and this. And I should be able to get no vignetting, perfectly flat field or nearly perfectly flat field. And it'll reduce my F10 down to, what is this, a 6.3? Yeah, so it would be a 10-inch telescope at F6.3. So we definitely have... a fast system for doing astrophotography with deep sky stuff. And of course, I would never use this when I was doing planetary work. I have a Teleview 4X Barlow that's 2 inches wide that I can use with my ASI monochrome camera, and I can do the planets with that, or I've got a Canon T3i that I can use as well for color if we wanted to look at Jupiter or Saturn, or something else that's quite colorful, in full color in real time, rather than capturing three mono images and then processing that, because that could be kind of a dull or a drag event to do live. So once again, we've gone ahead and deforked the tube. Wasn't nearly that difficult. If any of you guys are thinking one day that you might want to buy a large forked Meade telescope and defork it, but it sounds intimidating or daunting. As you can see, it really only took four bolts and three screws on each side, and I removed one fork arm and the rest of the telescope came right off with it. And I don't remember if I mentioned or not earlier, but the reason why I wanted to remove one of the arms and then take the bolts off the other side and roll it out is these arms are inflexible. I don't know that I'd be able to move them that much, and you want them that way. You don't want the arms to flex with your telescope on there. That can cause some problems when you're trying to find an object. They sandwich to the OTA very tightly, and I've got this ring here for the rear cell and this ring up here for the corrector plate, and I wasn't sure that I'd be able to slide this out without hitting this and causing problems. And there's no need to actually scratch the paint on here any more than is necessary, for risk of maybe gouging the aluminum and creating a soft spot, or possibly warping the tube itself, which would then make the corrector plate no longer orthogonal to everything, and that would just make collimation a real pain in the butt. So the OTA's been deforked. I got several upgrades that I'm going to do in the future, one of which is a automatic focuser to replace this. Once again, I'm going to flock the inside of the OTA. Could potentially install some cooling fans in the back. This thing has a 10-inch Pyrex mirror. Pyrex glass does retain heat, not nearly as bad as some of the other older mirrors like quartz crystal from what I read online. So it might need some assisted cooling. And if I do that, we'll definitely be doing videos of that for you guys so you can follow along and see how I do that and hopefully inspire you guys to maybe take on a project like this yourselves. So this has been a lot of fun. Actually, it hasn't. It was kind of boring. But it wasn't that difficult. So please, if you're thinking about doing this, don't let it intimidate you. It's just a few bolts and the OTA comes right off. So for those of you who did tune in, thanks for watching. And those of you who are watching after it's streamed live, again, thanks for watching. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you have not done so already. I'll be doing more live events in the future, and YouTube has a way of notifying you when I go live, the same way Facebook does when your friends do Facebook Live. That's the train of thought I was trying to get out. So if you subscribe to me on YouTube and I do a live event impromptu in the middle of the night because I finally got everything working and it's a clear night, I can begin broadcasting live. You get a notification on your smartphone or something and you can just follow along with me. So please be sure to subscribe if you think that would be interesting to take advantage of. And if you thought that this video was helpful, go ahead and like it. Share it to anywhere that you're normally found online, Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, any of the other websites like Cloudy Nights or Ice in Space. And you know, leave a comment. Let me know what you think. Did I do it right? Did I make a mistake that would have made this 10 times easier? Did you learn something new on how to do this? Do you have suggestions for the new color of the OTA? Do you have any other upgrade recommendations I haven't listed, like the cooling fans, the flocking on the inside? Maybe some of you are doing auto guiding with these and you know of a great guide scope to use. I've already got a guide camera, but I definitely would like a good guide scope to go with it. So recommendations for any of that stuff, please put it in the comments below. I would hugely appreciate any advice that you guys who have experience with something like this might be able to offer to somebody like me who is just now getting back into possibly doing deep sky astrophotography through a big light bucket. Again, thanks for watching and I hope you learned something new. I hope you have clear skies and as always, keep looking up.